बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वालैहि वसल्लम अल्लाहुम्मा रब्बी ज़िदनी इल्मा सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वालैहि वसल्लम आमीन अल्हम्दुलिल्लाहि रब्बिल आलमीन। द टॉपिक ऑफ दिस लेक्चर इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ परमुटेशंस विद रेपिटेशंस एन इम्पॉर्टेंट एडवाइस फॉर मी एंड फॉर एवरीवन वी मस्ट बी सॉफ्ट टू अदर्स। Permutations with repetitions. Well, don't use NPR for repeated or identical objects because NPR is only used for distinct objects. Formula for permutations with repetitions. If P, Q and R objects are repeated in N objects, then to arrange all objects, use this formula. N factorial divided by the factorial of the repeated objects, P factorial, Q factorial and R factorial. This is the way to arrange all objects when some objects are repeated. For example, if we have to arrange all 9 letters of the word aggregate at random, we will use this formula. 9 factorial divided by the factorial of the repeated letters. So there are 2 A's, 3 G's and 2 E's in aggregate. For example, if we have to arrange these 3 letters, so we will write 3 factorial divided by 2 factorial because there are 2 A's and these are 3 possible arrangements of these 3 letters. If we have to arrange all 6 letters, then we will write 6 factorial divided by factorial of 3 for 3 A's, 3 factorial for 3 A's and 2 factorial for 2 B's. This is the way to arrange these 6 letters at random. This example is very important. Requirement, we have to arrange 8 letters from the 9 given letters. So when we have to arrange less number of letters from all letters and when some letters are repeated, then we have to make all possible arrangements. We have to omit there are these letters, 2 A's, 2 E's, 3 G's and 2 other letters like R and T. So we have to make all possible arrangements with the repeated letters and without repeated letters like this. First we need to omit 1 A to arrange 8 letters from these 9 letters. So when we will omit 1 A, then we are 100% sure that there are 2 E's and 3 G's. So we will divide 8 factorial by this thing. Now we have to omit 1 G. So when we will omit 1 G, then we are 100% sure that we have 2 A's, 2 E's and 2 G's. So we can divide with 2 factorial for 2 A's, 2 factorial with 2 G's and 2 factorial with 2 E's. When we will omit 1 E, then we have to divide 8 factorial by 2 factorial for 2 A's and 3 factorial for 3 G's. Now we have to omit 1 R. There is just 1 R, so omit R. So when we will omit R, the letter R, then we will use this 8 factorial divided by 2 factorial for 2 A's, 2 factorial for 2 E's and 3 factorial for 3 G's. And when we will omit the letter T, then we will get the same thing. So we just need to multiply this answer by 2. Now we just need to add these numbers, the answers of these. This will give you the arrangements of 8 letters from the 9 letters of this word aggregate. Next concept. Leave the arrangements of identical objects because there is always just one way to arrange all or some identical objects. So if we have to arrange, given 5 ways and we have to arrange 5 ways, just write one. There is just one way to arrange 5 ways from 5 ways. If you want to show some working, then you can write this as 5 factorial over 5 factorial, which is here. If you have to arrange 3 A's from 5 A's, don't use 5P3 because you can never use P for repeated objects. Just write 1 way, or just write 3 factorial over 3 factorial. This is here. So 5 is just one way. If you want to show working, you can write 5 factorial divided by 5 factorial. Never use 5p5 because NPR is not used for identical objects. NPR is only for distinct objects. So 3 is from 5 is, don't use 5p3. Just write one way only. Or if you want to show working, write 3 factorial upon 3 factorial. So if you need 1a from 5 is, never use 5p1. Just write one way. Or 1 factorial over 1 factorial. Applications of box method. Well, box method is used when all the required objects are together. When all the required objects are together, then we always use box method. For example, in the word accommodation, the letters A, I, O must all be together. The question is, find the number of arrangements of all the letters of the word accommodation. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, kulli hal. In which the letters A, I, and O must all be together. So you have to keep these letters with repetition into this box, and you have to place the remaining letters into this box. And in remaining letters, there are 2 M's and 2 C's. So you have to use 6 factorial to arrange these 6 letters, and you need to divide 6 factorial by 2 factorial and 3 factorial, because there are 2 A's and 3 O's. This is for 3 O's. And you know, these are 7 objects and this is 1 object. So altogether we have 8 objects. And we need to divide 8 by 2 factorial for 2 M's and 2 factorial for 2 C's. So this is the way to arrange these 3 letters with repetition when all these 3 letters are together. Now, what if the question is, all these 3 letters must not be together? Use it when all the required objects are not together. For example, the letters A, I, and O must not all be together. Then you just need to subtract this answer from the total. So to solve this question, we always do this part first, and then we use this formula. So all not together means total minus all together. This minus this answer. Never use spaces method to solve these type of questions. I'm sorry. This is the example for you. This is the same example as we did this one, accommodation. So you can solve this yourself. The letters A, E, and I are all together in this word, and the letters A, E, and I are not all together. So you have to do this yourself. Number 3. So use it box method is used when exactly 2 objects are together and not together. This example is very simple. Like, for example, if we have the 6-7 letters of the word uniform, and this is the question, the letters F and M are together. So we can use box method. We can place F and M into this box and remaining letters into this box. So we need to use 2 factorial for these 2 letters, and this means 6 objects, because this is 1 object and these are 5 objects. So 5 plus 1 makes 6. And for not together, use this formula, total minus together. Spaces method. Well, applications. Well, this method is used when the objects are separated, when the required letters are separated. This is the best application of this method. For example, if we had 9 letters in the word green gauge and the requirement is the G's are separated. The G's are separated means even 2 G's cannot be together. So we have to first arrange the remaining letters. Remaining letters are 6 letters including 3 E's. So we have to make 6 spaces for remaining letters first. So 6 factorial divided by 3 factorial for 3 E's. Now we have to fill any 2 slots, any 3 slots because we have 3 G's. So any 3 out of 7. So 7P3. And all these 3 slots are same. So we need to divide 7P3 by 3 factorial. This 3 factorial is for 3 same filled slots like this. And this 3 factorial is for 3 E's over here. Second example, an application, in fact, application number 2 of a spaces method. Use this method when less identical objects are together from all identical objects. For example, if the question is exactly 2 G's are together from the arrangement of 9 letters of the word green gauge. So 2 G's from 3 G's, this means this thing, less number are together from more numbers. So this question is very important. You must not count the remaining G into remaining objects. Make sure you will count the remaining objects excluding the G. So 2 G's are together means 1 G is remaining. So you must not count that G as a remaining object. The remaining objects must not include the G. So these are 6 remaining objects and you can arrange them in this way. 6 factorial divided by 3 factorial. 3 factorial for 3 is. Now the question is exactly 2 G's are together. For that you need to fill 1 slot with 2 G's and 1 slot with 1 G. In this way 2 G's are together. Even if you place this G here, in this way these 2 G's are together. I mean this G will not be joined with these 2 G's. So the requirement is exactly 2 G's are together. So in this way exactly 2 G's are together. So you need to write 7P2 because you filled 2 slots out of 7. So make sure you fill 1 slot with 2 G's and 1 slot with 1 G. Any 1 slot with 2 G's and any 1 slot with 1 G out of 7. This is the third application. This is very important. Use it when some objects are together and some are not together. This question is very important. There are 2 restrictions in one question. Some objects are together and some objects are not together. Like in this example, we have 3 C's, 2 G's and 2 O's. Requirement, we have to arrange all 7 letters and 3 C's are all together and 2 G's are not together. So while using the spaces method, we first arrange the remaining objects and we count not together objects as the requirement. So requirement means the objects which are not together and which are 2 G's. So remaining objects means these 3 C's, these 2 O's. These 3 C's will be counted as a 1 single object according to the requirement that 3 C's are together. So we have 3 remaining objects and 2 objects are not together and this is the requirement. So first arrange the remaining objects by making 3 spaces for the remaining objects like this, 1, 2, 3. So these are 3 remaining objects, so we need to write 3 factorial and 2 objects are same like orange or 2 O's. So 2 factorial for 2 O's. Now we have to make 4 slots and we have to fill any 2 slots out of 4. So 4P2 and these 2 filled slots are same, so we need to divide 4P2 by 2 factorial. This question is very important. You have to consider 2 G's are not together as the requirement and the leftover letters as the remaining objects with condition that three C's are together. So you have to arrange three C's and two O's in this way. And then you have to fill any two slots out of four. And must divide 4P2 by 2 factorial because these two fill slots are same. And these two spaces are same, so divide this 3 factorial by 2 factorial. Relationship between NPR and NCR. Well, in permutations, these selections are done automatically. This is the formula of permutation. NPR is NCR into R factorial. This means selections and this means arrangements. For example, if we have to arrange four letters from the seven letters of the word uniform at random, then we normally write 7P4, but we can do this in this way as well, 7C4 into 4 factorial. You can first select four letters at random from seven letters of the word uniform, and then you can arrange these four letters randomly. So this means 7P4. Application of this formula. While basically we use this formula when there are restrictions either in selections or in arrangements or in both. So if selections are restricted or arrangements are restricted, or if there are restrictions in both, then we use this formula to arrange the objects. And this is the best example to understand that formula. 9 cards each of a different color are to be arranged in a line. The 9 cards include a pink card and a green card. So there are 9 cards which include a pink and a green card. Consider all possible choices of 3 cards from the 9 cards, with the 3 cards being arranged in a line. Number 1, how many different arrangements in total of 3 cards are possible? This is so simple, you have to arrange 3 cards out of 9, so you can write 9P3, or you can use this formula as well. You can select any 3 cards from 9 first, and then you can arrange those 3 cards randomly. So 9P3, or this means the same thing. Now this part is very important. How many of the arrangements of 3 cards in this part 1 contain the pink card? So we first need to arrange, we first need to select the cards with one pink card. So selections are restricted. So first select pink card and 2 other cards from the remaining 8 cards. This part is very important. So selections are restricted and arrangements are random. So first select 3 cards. Pink card, so write 1C1 for the pink card. There is just one pink card, so 1C1. And we need 2 more cards from the remaining 8 cards. So we should write 8C2. In this way, we have selected 3 cards. And we had to select 3 cards. Now arrange these 3 cards randomly, because there are no restrictions in arrangements. The restrictions are only in selections. So there are 168 ways to arrange 3 cards, including a pink card. Now this last part is extremely important. See, how many arrangements of 3 cards in part 1 does not have the pink card next to the green card? Now this is very important. Three cards in part 1, this is the answer of part 1. They are saying how many arrangements of 3 cards in part 1 do not have the pink card next to the green card. So restrictions are there in both selections and arrangements. So first we need to select 3 cards including the pink card and green card with one more card from the remaining 7 cards. So selection of pink and G can be written in this way, 2C2. And we need one more card from the remaining 7 cards, so 7C1, because altogether we need 3 cards. Now we have to arrange these 3 cards in this way. P and G are together. So for PG together, we can use box method. So for PG, we should write 2 factorial. There is just one remaining card because altogether we had 3 cards. So one is here. This is one object and this is one. So altogether this means 2 objects, 2 factorial. So 2 factorial times 2 factorial, this means P and G are together. And 2C2 into 7C1, there are, means their selections. So this will give you P and G are together. But the question is, how many arrangements of 3 cards in part 1 do not have the pink card next to the green card? For that, you need to subtract this answer from the total, which is the answer of part 1. So answer of part 1 is 504 minus 28 will give you the requirement.